say?
He's worthy.
He's worthy to be praised.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I'm just going to let God have his way. The house has already been addressed. Y'all pray for me. Y'all forgive me. I'm just a praiser. When I get up here, I have to praise God to break these nerves a little bit. Is that okay? Look, this is going to be a corresponding message today. Okay? So it's going to cause a little bit of participation. Y'all with me? So I need you to look at your neighbor and just tell them one word. Say break out.
Break, break out. Out.
Come on and break tell out. Them break out.
Break, break out.
Yes, yes. Break out. The key verse is going from 1 Corinthians, the 10th verse. I'm sorry, the 10th chapter, the 13th verse. And it says, there has no temptation taken but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above ye are able. But you will, with the temptation, also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. Now, I'm going to go ahead and read that again. I'm going to read it in a new NIV version, okay? It's going to break it down a little bit. It said, there's no temptation that has overtaken you except that it is common to mankind. And God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. Now tell your neighbor that God will put no more on me. Come on, talk to him. That God will put,
no more on me
than I can bear.
Than I can bear.
Mm-hmm. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can endure. There is a way of escape. We're going to go to our lesson scripture. Our lesson scripture is going to come from Acts the 16th, the 25 through the 31st verse. You was all over my message, missionary. You was all over, but God. He said, but at midnight, Paul and Silas was praying and singing hymns to God. And the prisoners was listening to them. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake so that the foundation of the prisons were shaken. And immediately, all the doors was open and everyone's chains was loose. And the keeper of the prison drew his sword about to kill himself. But Paul called in a loud voice saying, do yourself no harm. We are all here. Yes. Then he called for a light, ran in, and fell down. I'm sorry. Then he called for a light and fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. And he brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? So they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved. And you and your household. Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all that was in his house. And he took them the same hour of the night, washed their stripes, and immediately he and all his families were baptized. Yeah. Now when he had brought them unto his house, he set food before them, and he rejoiced having believing in God with all his household. Now, we often hear about Paul and Silas being locked in the prison, getting chained up. But let's take a step back. I want to take a step back. Let's go up a little further. What did they do to get in jail? What did they do to even get in jail? It said they was on their journey, and they was traveling down there to the Philippi, and they was at Lydia's house, and it so happened to be the Sabbath day, and they were just going to prayer. And here come this spirit, this woman, filled with this divination spirit, which is witchcraft. And she began, and she was telling the truth, saying what all they was doing. But what got me when it said Paul became annoyed and turned around and said to the spirit, I command you in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out that very same hour. Now let's get a little background on this lady. She was a slave. And she had masters. And she was making her money. But see, when Paul became annoyed and cast that spirit out, it made the enemy mad. Why did it make the enemy mad? It cost them their money. Anything that costs your money, you're going to be upset, right? But here it is, what I wanted to focus on, it was that Paul became annoyed with the spirit. And God been beginning to deal with me. He said, you've been dealing with this stuff all year long. You've been dealing with that spirit. You're dealing with this spirit. You're dealing with that spirit. When are you going to become annoyed with that spirit? You ought to get tired of being sick and tired of the enemy beating up on you. And you get to a point, you know how you ever got to the point where you get so fed up? You didn't care what the consequences was, but something gonna have to shake. You ought to get to the point where you get tired of being sick and tired of the enemy beating up on you. You ought to get tired of walking around and saying, I'm so depressed. I don't know what I'm going to do. My light bill due. I got a gas bill too. Lord, I ain't got no money. You ought to get tired and say, God, I know you got this. In the name of Jesus, God, you handle it. So Paul came annoyed, cast the spirit out. Woman got saved, but the masters wasn't happy. So they got locked up. It is what it is. They got locked up. And so here they were bound in prison. Shackled down. This is what got me. When they were shackled down, they just didn't sit there. Sister Prince, I'm going to need your help today. They just didn't sit there. They just didn't let the enemy have free course. But when they were sitting there, they were singing and they was praying. They were singing and they was praying. They were singing and they was praying. See, oftentimes when we go through, we get too quiet. Oftentimes when we go through, we just shut down. But if we begin to open our mouth and we begin to shout unto God, and we just utter out a thank you, Jesus, a hallelujah, God, I bless you. If we just begin to sing, God, your mercies endure forever. And we just begin to open our mouth. Hey. Open your mouth. Don't let the enemy defeat you. Now, here's the kicker. While they were singing and praying, the other prisoners had no idea what was going on. But God placed them there for such a time as that. So oftentimes when you go through, you don't might not understand, but you're going through for your sister. You're going through for your brother. And God putting you in a position to bless them. That's how God works. It's not for yourself. They had no idea what was going on. But as they began to sing and pray, as they began to shout unto God, singing him, they said suddenly, immediately, what I heard in these scriptures, suddenly and immediately, there became a earthquake, and it shook the prison. And it said immediately, not just Paul and Silas' chains were loose, Everybody chains were loose.
Yeah, yeah.
So I dare you, if you want to break out, if you want to be free, if you want your family to be free, don't just sit there. Get up on your feet. Shout unto God. Begin to praise Him. Begin to magnify Him.
Yeah.
Exalt His name. Because I promise you, the same God that delivered Paul and Silas is the same God that will step in and deliver you. Missionaries say that's nothing new under the sun. But in order to break out, you got to do something. You got to do something.
You got to do something.
Yeah. Open up your mouth. Now, the Bible said, whether it's two or three gathered in my name, I will be in the midst. He said, one can chase 1,000. Two can chase 10,000. I dare. I just need two or three people that don't mind. Come on, breaking out. Say, we coming out. I'm not leaving you behind. I'm not leaving you behind. I dare two or three people. Open up your mouth and begin to praise God. Shake loose.
Yeah.
Shake it off. Shake it off. Don't wait on me. Open up your mouth.
Yeah.
Open up your mouth. Say, I'm coming out.
Coming out.
I'm breaking out.
Yeah.
Break out!
Yes.
Break out! I dare you!
Yeah.
I dare you! I dare you! I dare you! Praise Him for your sister!
Yeah.
Praise Him for your brother!
Yeah.
Praise Him for those kids! I dare you!
Yeah.
Oh, whatever street, we coming out! We coming out!
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Keep it right there. And so, when God began to deal with me about breakout, He began to deal with me about a game called the escape room. Anybody know what the escape room is? Come on, young people, the breakout room. And so when I went to look it up, Pastor, it's a game where you get blindfolded. You get blindfolded. And you go and you are put in a room. You don't know how you got there. But only thing you know, you got so many minutes to break out. Huh. So he said, keep on looking. Then I ran across the movie called The Escape Room. And see, the enemy will fool you. Uh-huh. They were sent a special invitation. Different people to come to win $1,000,000. Say, somebody say, babe, money talk.
Money talk.
Money talk. And so when they went, and they went to the address, and they thought they was going to just meet the people to talk about the game. But when they went in, they found themselves in the escape room. And when they found themselves in the escape room, little did they know they had to fight for their life. That it was no ordinary game. It's either you play the game and escape or be killed. But the key about it is that they had to work together. Now today we're going to pretend that we are in the escape room. And we're about to break out. But we have to work together to get some results. And I said earlier, there is a way of escape. Well, Sister Dorita, how do we escape? Jesus is the way. He is the way, the truth, and the life.
Yeah.
No man comes but by Him. Jesus is the way of escape. So if we want to escape what we're going through, if we want to escape that situation, if we want to escape that problem, we have to go through Jesus. And all the thing He said we had to do was call on Him. He said, call on Him. So we in the escape room. And we know Jesus is the way of escape. He already gave us our directions. We don't even have to guess it. So we call on Jesus. He know that he will answer prayer. Now listen. I'm going to say this and I'm done. When it got on down to the movie, he said, study this thing, study it. So when it got on down to the movie, and Sister David got to the end, and it revealed, and they got the paperwork, they said they knew everything about us. They knew every trauma. They knew every situation. They knew every trigger. And said, when the enemy knows you, then you must be doing something for God. He said, Paul, I know. But if the enemy don't know you, you better check yourself. The enemy knows everything about you. He knows your trigger. He knows what you've been through. Yeah. The enemy knew everything about them. And I'm here to tell you, the enemy knows everything about you. If you're working for God, it's not going to be a bed of roses. But again, there is a way of escape. Now, if you want to escape, I'm not going to bad nobody. So I just need 2-3 people today. If you're ready to escape the situation, if you're ready to break out of depression, if you're ready to break out of financial difficulties, if you're tired of the enemy beating up on you, I dare you to stand up on your feet. And we're going to be in the escape room today. That we come